Like that pile behind me. So what I'll take a step away. I guess I'll say real quick about the yesterday's events, because that thing was just not my cup of tea. I knew it wasn't going to be. Sorry, I'm putting this stuff away. I knew it wasn't going to be. It's been a long time since I've been in a really, really Baptist type church. And the legalism and stuff just tends to, oh my goodness, what's happening over here? Hold on, I can't get this stuff back in the bag. So I only have one hand, so I'm holding the phone. Excuse my clothes up. Hi. No makeup. It's a real thing. Or hairbrush. Okay, so anyway. Hold on. Sorry. Anyway, so it was a really nice gesture for my sister-in-law to invite me. And it was nice to bring my mother there before we went. We went to my grandma's graveyard, like her, my grandma and aunt and uncle and great aunt and great uncle and stuff and their plot and everything. And that was nice with my mom. So it was nice to take my mom. But my sister and my sister-in-law, it's her church, and my sister was there. They didn't arrive till like 40 minutes late. And because originally, but we were like 20 minutes early on top of that. So we're just sitting in the car. But on top of everything, like, I originally wanted to just leave mom, because she was, after the event, she was going over my sister-in-law and brother's house. But they weren't there, so I kind of was just like, alright, I guess I'll go. It just, the people in the church were nice, the food was just, was okay. They had ham, somebody made a ham, it was so good. And it was just, but a lot of it was not very good, and I didn't eat enough, of what was good. But it was just, and like my sister-in-law forgot to tell me that it was dress-up, so everyone was there was in, like, super churchy clothes, dresses, and, you know, button-up shirts and stuff, and so I was like, not, which is fine, but, but it was mostly just the speaker that turned me off. A woman spoke, and I'm not even gonna get into it, because I already went into it with Peter, but it was just, one of the most pretentious things I'd ever heard it, or not ever heard, but had heard in a long time. Like, this woman was just, long story short, her husband had been in the military, had PTSD after like 3 deployments, came home, and was a different man, you know, of course that happens, but anyway, I guess he got into a bunch of stuff, and he ended up, the whole marriage just, everything went bad, and she left, he left them, and had, you know, and had an affair or whatever, but anyway, the whole thing was like, she had a PowerPoint presentation, which I haven't even, like, seen a PowerPoint presentation in, like, eons, but, and it just became like this, PTSD is a mental health issue that, you know, not a lot of Christians acknowledge, and I was like, oh yeah, you know, that's true, then it just became this, like, but, what was actually sin, and he was, just became a bad, evil man, so she was knocking that, and then they ended up getting divorced. It was like a long divorce. She's a single mother. And then she ended up knocking divorce like crazy, which, you know, I don't think divorce is a great thing. You know, I wish it didn't have to be a thing. But as someone who would give my right and left arm, you know, to be able to afford and get a divorce from the man I'm with, I understand that sometimes it's a better option for children. It really is. But anyway, but she was like going on about how it was such a horrible thing and how she wanted to make sure when she found a church and everything that they did not believe in divorce and they thought divorce was horrible. Not just like a bad thing, but like sinful. And then the third thing was she went on and on about, this is what gets me about the legalistic side of Baptists and other groups too, but not all Baptists are like this. Southern Baptists are not, tend to be like this. And, but, anyway, the more fundamental you get, the more legalistic things tend to get. Trust me, I've grown up in many a Baptist church in my life. she went on and on about how her kids were doing so well and where they were in life. One of her kids was older and one was, like, still in school. And every statement she said had to do with how her kids were so good. She ended up saying that her kids were all good people because they all did the right Christian things. They went to the right Christian clubs. They went to the right Christian school. She drives 45 minutes so her son can be in a Christian school. And it was just this huge long tirade about how her kids are good people because they did all the right Christian things. And then, of course, it was followed by because of God. But mostly it was just this huge thing about how good our kids are. My daughter's going on a missions trip, and she's going to do good, and she's in the right college, and she has good friends. And then she was talking about her own job, how she has to work a couple different jobs, and she turned down jobs that were not in the right field because they weren't Christian jobs, which basically just ended up being this whole rant about, like, how God provided her with the right job because it was a Christian job. Like, I don't know if people even, like, her realize when they talk, but what it ends up sounding like is, if your kids are not in all the Christian programs, the Christian school, the right Christian college, this Christian, that Christian, that, they're not as good. If you're working a job that is not in a Christian school, or not a Christian counseling job, or not a ministry job, it's not as God-led. Like, it was so pretentious. And again, I don't even know if she realize she sounds this way, but it happens a lot. It's just, and everyone in the audience was like, all the women were like, yeah, yes, yes, you know, like, preach it, sister, except not preach it, because women can't be preachers, which is true, but, you know. Anyway, but it was super pretentious, and I was, like, livid, because I was just disgusted by it, and this whole concept of, you know, God will provide you with, if you keep looking and keep having faith, God will give you a good Christian job and a good Christian life, and, like, as if you are in something else, it's not as good. Which most people don't have the luxury of having a wonderful, you know, high-paying Christian job. Anyway, it was super pretentious. I was super disgusted. And then after that, it was supposed to, I had been told it was, like, from 6 to 8:30. But then after the whole thing, they're like, we're gonna play a game. And they were like, hey, giggly women. And I was just like, and it was 100 degrees, and I was just bored and hungry and frustrated. And the night went on way too long. They played two games, and the games were okay. They were kind of like, one of them was, you know, what phone scavenger hunt, you know, if you have this in your phone or on your phone, you know, you get points. And the other one was one of those word associations, like three words and what do they have in common. But it was so long. They took so long. And I was super frustrated with my sister-in-law because there's some drama going on there. And she's gotten really preachy lately. And she kind of has become the daughter that our mother, you know, wanted. Like, super Baptist. And she's super... yeah, it's just a lot of stuff going on, family stuff, but it was just not a good night, and today has been okay. It's not the worst. The boy's father's bringing home pizza because it's super late, and we were kind of just all resting, and, you know, so that's for dinner, because tomorrow's sweet stamp day. So anyway, that's my Mother's Day rundown. I'm tired. Whoa. Nobody wants to see my fat face. Anyway, so, yeah, that's the rundown, and I'm going to try to edit this and get it up tonight. It's super rainy and cold. It's so cold. I'm super congested now that I laid down. Forever with sinus issues. My life. Anyway, so if you watch this, thank you. Feel free to like, subscribe, feel free to hit the notification bell so you can tell when I upload a video, since I don't currently have an official schedule. And, I hope you're having a good day, or a good night, or a good whatever. And if you're a mom, kudos to you. Being a mom is hard. Like, seriously, it is hard-ass work. But rewarding, because your kids make you cute stuff. And even if you're not a sentimental person like me, it's still cute. So, have a good one. I'll see you next time. Bye.